result of John Paul's intervention. A miracle. Hundreds of thousands of Catholic pilgrims are expected to descend on the Vatican for the beatification on May
1st. He's ready.
I know, night and day from last time. Here's my problem. Before I even begin, you see that corner up there? All right, if you're over here, you can see that there's a crack that goes along the ceiling up to about here, all the way down to the radiator. Now, a couple of days ago, I spotted water coming out of that crack. Here's the problem. I know this water, this wall is wet. I have an outlet here. How do I know that the water is not getting into the outlet?
Are you using that outlet?
Not anymore.
Did you try using it?
If I use it and water comes into contact with electricity, you have a fire.
But you didn't try it. You didn't use
it. I shut off the circuit basically. So I have literally no electricity around here.
And why did you do that for?
Because if you have water coming into contact with electricity, you get a fire. You get a spark out of it. You get a short circuit. I don't need that kind of hassle. So even though the water damage is over on that side, inevitably it's going to start coming through there, it's going to start coming through here, and I need some assurance that if water starts coming through, what do I do? Because if I turn on the electricity, I've started a fire. If I leave it off, I have no electricity anymore. Now, it's one thing I understand with the bathroom ceiling, it's got to be repaired, water's still coming through, we can't touch it. But when the other circuit is no longer available, there's no electricity to be had. Everything I've got is battery operated now.
Can you turn on the electricity? Did you have a problem with any of it?
Hasn't flickered, but this was a precautionary measure. Uh-huh. I'll turn on this circuit and the kitchen.
Yeah, please.
And the hallway. You never remember which is which.
I know.
Here we go. I'm not touching that outlet for squat. But if you look here, you can see the trails that are coming down from the wall. If you look down here, you can see a splash pattern. I mean, this is not a coffee stain.
Mm-hmm.
But yeah, go right ahead.
Mm-hmm. When was that?
Well, I discovered this.
Is it most recently or
This was very recent, January 10th. So you got a mark right there.
Oh, doggy.
Ooh.
I know, that's
directly
that one
into the flash. Oh, man. Okay.
I'm sorry.
So you got that. You got this crack coming down here. I just knocked something over there. And you've got that wonderful ripple pattern right down here.
Okay, huh?
So the immediate concern is, there's definitely water coming up here, but now that you guys know, because it's the same thing that happened in the bed. You know, the water will always travel downwards.
Yeah,
it will eventually
problem,
hit there.
Yeah.
And I can tell that's the beginnings of water damage. Mm-hmm. So eventually it's going to come down, it's going to hit the outlet. Mm-hmm. So if I can get like assurance that what to do in the event of, you know, water coming out of there, that would be great. Mm-hmm. It's just a small favor I'd ask. Mm-hmm. But this is brand spanking new. Like less than a week old.
Uh-huh.
So that was thing one. Thing two is a little more immediate. Has anybody seen the exterminator in the last 3 months?
They were supposed to come today, but they called. They're going to come on Monday. Are you going to be home on Monday?
Monday's a holiday.
I know, that's what they left a message, so.
I was supposed to have a meeting on that day to take advantage of the holiday. All right, I'll leave a note. I'll have him contact me because this is the third time in a row. It's second Thursday of the month. He's not here,
mm-hmm.
Which leads us to our next problem. Now, I've mentioned there was a hole in the cabinetry over there.
Mm-hmm.
I've mentioned there's a hole up here, and I'm pretty sure, don't hold me to it, but I'm pretty sure at one point I have seen a mouse stick its head out there. You yes, laugh, but...
You know, I saw it one time on my cabinet, the same thing,
okay.
And you wondered, I would never say that they could climb that high.
They can climb.
Ew. Oh.
They've been here.
So I believe you, that's why I laugh, because yeah. I believe you, I saw a mouse in my house, the same thing.
It gets worse, okay? I know there's a hole there over the gas line.
Uh-huh.
I'm finding droppings there.
Uh-huh.
I went out, I had surgery back in November. I came back, I literally had, pardon my French, I literally had rat shit over this counter, in my best cooking pot, in my coffee mug.
I know,
they're gonna, that's what they, Because I'm thinking, you know, if the landlord's paying this guy, he's not showing up,
yeah,
he's throwing good money after that.
Yeah,
it's a waste.
They call and they said that they're gonna come on Monday, so hopefully...
They better show, because I know I'm not alone.
Oh, you're not alone, I have my daughter just saw a mouse in my house.
Yeah.
So I think it's,
I don't,
that's something that comes and goes.
If you find him, just hold him down, we'll all jump him.
yeah.
But meanwhile, we still got the hole from back here, we've got a hole here, we've got a hole under here. I don't want to look down there. I don't want to look down there. Because it's just full of droppings.
And how big is the hole? We have to think at the height.
It's just that bad. But they fit right through.
Yeah.
So you can see.
Yeah.
And I cleaned this
yeah,
6 months ago, so. Here, you got a good angle right here. You go to university, you got a degree in camerography. Someone's got to use it, right?
Yeah.
But it's just...
And you're mentioning this hole in this cabinet too, or...?
Right under this duct tape. That's the only thing holding it out right now.
Uh-huh.
Given a matter of time, they're going to come through.
Yes.
Behind the stove, they love to congregate there.
Oh, they do. That's their favorite spot.
But my least favorite is... Okay, so I'm cleaning everything on back my cat's surgery. She's like a pretty disaster.
Come
up from back here.
Yeah.
They're climbing up the back.
Once they're in,
they're
very friendly people. They don't like to leave you. I know.
If they pay the rent, I have no problem with that.
Of course. Bring them all, right?
Exactly. They can have their little corner. I got mine. I'll teach them how to use the toilet.
As long as they don't bother you.
As long as they're, you know, helping out, no problem.
Yeah,
but they're a nuisance, and I can't get these people.
He's going to come on Monday. They left a message. Hopefully, they're going to come.
Hopefully,
if any change, we will let you know.
Okay.
That's what
so
we said.
Those are the big ones. Here's the one I just discovered now. Now, you might remember I had some duct tape up here in order to keep the mice in certain areas. That way you can catch and trap them or do whatever I got to do.
I know.
I've given up. See how it hangs here against the wall? Put your finger through that one.
Somebody keeping on you. Hopefully not.
Oh, yeah,
you'll see that.
They're coming right through. So now we know where the mice are coming.
Oh, I thought you would see through the other apartment. I'm like,
No. That would be uninterested. I'd let them know. But that's where the mice are coming through. So they're coming through that closet, those holes.
That hole there, right?
That.
Okay, that's what's fixable.
So all that's got to be warfarin or whatever the hell we use.
Plastered.
Plaster it up, let it sit.
Mm-hmm.
But there's another problem. Again, in the closet, upper right-hand side, all the way at the top, on the right, further right there. You see that V pattern going down the wall? That's water damage. So not only are they hanging out in my kitchen, which I think is a compliment, so, I mean, they must like my food, right?
Yeah.
But they're drinking water there, so they're going to call that place home. They're not going away.
Okay, you got a leak, for example, here, you have a radiator, so the same pattern goes up. But over here, there is no radiator.
But it's coming down from something.
There is no sink.
The only thing I can think of is natural gas, and if that's the case, I should have smelled it by now.
Of course.
So, I don't know what that is.
Maybe they spilled something.
It's a possibility. Ooh, that reminds me, the refrigerator. There was a guy who you called 3 years ago, around the time that this was supposedly repaired. The refrigerator, you're going to have to call him back, because that fridge needs de-icing.
Okay.
Uh-huh. Otherwise, it starts leaking. And
Because so is your refrigerator working now, or is
It is now. It's been off for a while because I let everything melt out. I put two coffee cans there, but eventually they're going to give up.
Yeah.
So just call the guys in, have them redo it, and have them not break it this time.
I know.
God, they're slow. They're going with a hammer, so they're hammering away at the ice. Makes sense. The guy slips, smacks the refrigerator part of it, almost knocks the light bulb out.
Wow, and one hole in a refrigerator
is gone. And it's got Freon because it's old, so all that.
Yeah. How old is the refrigerator?
I'd say a 1970s model, but...
Yeah, but exactly up on everything
the...
goes the same. This line is all the same, so must be.
It's got to be the steam riser.
Must be the ring. Must be that.
That's going to be fun. Okay, those are the biggies. The rest is the same as the last time. The water, the bathroom ceiling is just, it's still dripping. You run your hand against it, you just
it's
give it a push.
It's not all the time, right? It's just sometimes, right?
Well, from the light fixture, it's sometimes. It's like once a month. And by the time you spot it, it's already stopped dripping.
Yeah.
But the other one in the far corner, I'll show you. So, yeah. Since I have no light on this side of the apartment.
Yeah. No, you could put it on. I don't think it's...
I am not risking it, because I've seen water come out of that. I'm not risking it.
Okay, but as long as this one is off.
It's off. It's been
yeah,
off.
So the as long as this one is off, I'm going to
put your hand right here.
Okay, we'll see. I'm gonna see if we have the metal sheet for the under the sink and behind the refrigerator. Also, this.
Yeah, this is a big problem. Because I know it's heating season. You can't do anything while it's heating season.
So you just noticed it, right? It's not.
Yeah, I just noticed it. Like, I wasn't even paying attention. I just saw this bean come down. Thinking that's not right. Made a note of it, and then the next day another bean came down.
Uh-huh.
Haven't seen anything since, but I haven't been around much. So uh-huh. It's possible that it could be, you know, having a big party. I don't know. Maybe I should ask the mice, because they're always here.
Yeah, but, you should.
But unfortunately, they don't speak New Yorker. So. But that's the new one, and that crack is just, it's going to get worse before it gets better.
I hope it's from the radiator. I'm gonna call the lady upstairs and see that she.
Because in the meantime, when are we gonna get this bathroom ceiling? Because I cannot wake up in the morning and shit in the dark. I can't come home from work and use the bathroom in the dark.
Yeah.
And it's been 3 years now. Mm-hmm. So that's all the news that's fit to print, as they say. Mm-hmm. The rest of it is minor stuff, but those are the big three.
Mm-hmm. Okay, I'll see you and let you know. Are you going to be around during the weekend, or are you going away?
I'm not entirely sure, because I just realized Monday's a holiday, and I said Monday noon, and I don't want to get stressed working on Monday. It's not fair. So, I called it early. I figured we'll get it over with by the weekend, but this weekend, I really have no idea what's going on.
Mm-hmm. I'll let you know. Can I have your phone number?
Sure. Chat.
And I'll look for the metal sheet if we have.
Right.
And then over the weekend, if you're going to be home, maybe we could come and do at least some of it, you know?
Sure. Promise, I remember my phone number by letters because I don't remember by number.
Yeah, 646 to defend?
No, it's a new one.
New one?
It's a new one. This is a business one, so it's 347-HTML-90. Let me look it up, because I don't know. I'm about to change phones, so anyway, so it's unbelievable that they'll charge you.
AT&T, Verizon?
Oh, even worse. I've been with Verizon, I've been with AT&T, and I am sick of both of them, to be quite honest.
Why don't you get the Metro PCS?
I'm considering it.
It's one flat rate, it's good. You talk day and night, same
rate.
Yeah,
but if they make you buy a new phone, you've wasted money on the phone. You're not saving anything.
But you don't have to buy some fancy phone, whatever. For me, whatever.
I know, but phone, once you're comfortable with it, once something works, don't mess with it, you know?
I know.
So anyway, here you go. Here's the new number. And like I said, I don't know if I'm going to be available this weekend. I'm trying to rearrange everything.
I know. I'm saying two, and then something come up, and then you feel like, you know, that's why.
Yeah.
But I'm going to look for it.
Okay.
Let you know, and then let me know if you're going to be home.
Okay.
My guess
is maybe Saturday I might be in, or Sunday I might be out. It's in flux. I've already made out 5 calls saying, don't expect me.
I know. I understand. Well,
plus I got a party to throw sometime next week, so that's one of the reasons this place is so majestic. But give me a call. Worst case scenario, I'll say, no, I have to reschedule.
Mm-hmm. No problem. We'll keep in touch, okay?
All right, because, he knows.
Okay, thank you.
All right,
have a
good weekend.
You too. Thank you.
And give my regards to the super, wherever he's gone off to.
I will.
Light has been out for 3 years. The water damage is well documented. I've had guests over. They know about it. Why doesn't the superintendent show up? He's busy. Obviously not here. The water damage I've pointed to here is going to grow. It's inevitable. They won't do any repairs. Within 6 months, I'll have water coming out of the outlet down here. That mice hole, that mouse hole, it was just discovered today, approximately 2 hours ago. Pays to clean up sometimes. The leak coming from the steam risers over here and the gas line here, I have no idea what the hell it is. I don't want to know. All I'm thinking is, can mice chew through a gas line? You'll notice that the superintendent isn't here. You can never get the superintendent when you want him. That's the end of the story, Jerry. So to prove date and time, you haven't hit the radio.
Concluding that they can't make it here in New York. So they're setting their sights on more affordable cities, such as Austin. Now the top U.S. destination for people ages 25 to 34. Census data from the Brookings Institution puts the Big Apple at a depressing number 52 on the list of metro areas. The director of the Center for an Urban Future tells AM
New York's number
costs in New York have shot through the roof in the last 10 years. At the same time, a lot of other cities have become increasingly desirable. She was 11 years old when she starred in the Broadway hit The Lion King, and now a bone marrow donor registry drive is being organized in her memory. Shannon Tavares died in November of leukemia. Thousands of people registered as bone marrow donors, but a perfect match for her was not found. On Sunday, the Bone Marrow Transplant Center, DKMS, will hold a donor drive at the Harlem School of the Arts from 1 to 7 p.m.
I'll get better
over time. The registry requires a simple swab of the inner cheek. Let's use time 519.
519.
From the team that brought you Hairspray comes a new Broadway musical. Based on the incredible true story and the hit film, this is Catch Me If You Can. Featuring a dynamite cast of Broadway's brightest stars and an original score to set Broadway's tone.
Broadway Studios, the comedy from the time that brought you Hairspray. Previews begin March 7th. line and clear at 5:20 on this Friday, January 14th. I'm Brian Carey. Here's what's happening. No more excuses, New Yorkers, that you can't afford to join the gym because the city is offering to shake you up for free. Pope John Paul II is officially on his way to sainthood. We'll have local reaction. A convicted mob boss will be 100 by the time he gets out of prison. He's already 93. Charlie Sheen has had his share of troubles, but the star of 2.5 Men has the total support of his network. Then when's AccuWeather? Partly cloudy tonight, low 18 in Midtown, 5 in some of the suburbs, above freezing, and not a bad day tomorrow.
The Jets get set to visit the Patriots this weekend. Knicks tonight entertain the Kings. Nets call on the Lakers. The Devils visit Tampa Bay.
Wings News time 5:20. Angelo Sorkin Community Health tries to organize a crew of tenants board in the reality TV show that should have given Greenspan a clue. Wings News time 5:21. It's time for the Vegas Discount Tire Traffic and Transit Report on the one.
This is not post-production.
Plenty of Friday getaway delays on the LIE to Queens and in the Nassau County Lakeville Road Dam Pass. The Northern State out towards Jericho Turnpike towards 106 and 7. Back into the five boroughs, the cross island south is jammed from the Tri-State Bridge to Bayside Marina with an accident in the right lane. And both sides of Manhattan really tough. The FDR drive from the 40s all the way back to the G-Red. Same deal on the west side. The Major Deegan is jammed coming up from Willis Avenue and southbound side coming down from the area of Van Cortlandt Park. Cross Bronx is still jammed off of the New England Thruway back up to the G-Red. And here's what you need to know about the bridges and tunnels. Heavy traffic through the tolls, Queensbound, Whitestone, and Frognack Bridges. Close to 40 minutes in both directions at the Lincoln Tunnel. I see long delays along 11th Avenue for blocks and blocks heading to the outbound Lincoln Tunnel. Other approaches just as bad. The outbound Holland Tunnel, 25-minute delay to get the worst of it on the inbound side is also the Lincoln Tunnel, close to a 40-minute delay. Tappan Zee overloaded crossing into Rockland County, and the Brooklyn-bound E and C trains have delays up to 30-minute departure delays at Newark and LaGuardia. Alternate sides suspended tomorrow. I'm Matt Ward on 1010 WIN.
The next Mavis Discount Tire Traffic reports in 10 minutes and log on and save at MavisTire.com with News Time 5:22.
Okay, 5:22, January 14th, 2011.